Welcome, dear participants. I am Research Assistant Dinçer Aydın from Trak University. Today I will present our paper titled as A Comparative Case Study on Investigation of Volatile Organic Compounds in Higher Education Buildings, which is prepared with my professors Friz Umaroğulları and Esma Mutlayanlar as a final work of our scientific research project. Let me start with the structure of the study. The study consists of four different sections. First section starts with the introduction and it includes the brief explanation of indoor air quality and occupant health, what is VOC, and finally the aim of the study. In second section, I will explain the materials and methods of the study. In this section, you can find description of the case buildings and methodology of the study. Third section includes the result and discussion of the study under three subheadings, as you can see measured values and both comparison results in the literature and specific to the studies in Turkey. Finally, I will summarize the study with our conclusions. The Environmental Protection Agency reported that pollution is 2 to 5 times higher indoors than outdoors. Therefore, it is very important that indoor air quality must meet human health and comfort conditions. Based on building functions, there are acceptable limits to the pollutants in the standards. One of the important standards belongs to the American Society of Heating, Refrigerating and Air Conditioning Engineers. Indoor air quality of buildings must be regulated according to limit values in this kind of standards. Because poor indoor air quality in a building can cause health problems on the occupants of buildings. These building-related health problems, which are a threat to occupants' health and productivity, are called sick building syndromes. These also lead to economic problems, as you see in the figure. However, it must be noted that management of indoor air quality in buildings, especially public spaces, such as educational buildings, where occupants in different profiles come together, is so difficult. So we can describe the indoor air quality as the air in which the pollutants known in it are not at the levels of harmful concentrations determined by the authorities at least 80% of the people in the environment do not feel any dissatisfaction with the quality of the air. One of the important pollutants for indoor is volatile organic compounds, also called as VOC. VOCs can occur from building materials such as paint, polish, carpet covering, composite wood panels, some insulation materials, and various decoration materials and household products such as household textile and cleaners, furniture, and also some cosmetics. VOCs with a high level of emissions from these materials used in the buildings cause poor indoor air quality. It has resulted in many studies that VOCs cause various diseases such as respiratory disease and also cancers. Especially for education buildings, apart from building itself, many potential sources for VOCs exist inside of the buildings, so that many materials which students use in workshops and laboratories, particular printers and photocopy machines, cause VOC emissions. After conducting a literature review on the VOCs in education buildings, we saw that in many countries similar studies are done. We listed some of these studies in the table. You can see the countries, the degrees of the analyzed education buildings, and which parameters were investigated. And also, under the scope column, you can find the number of buildings or classrooms in the studies and date or seasons when the studies were conducted. According to this table, it is seen that the common parameter in indoor air quality studies is VOC. Besides, the intersection seasons of this research are winter. Moreover, apart from one of the studies, it was determined that most of them were conducted for primary and secondary schools. It can be said that this is the result of the impact of VOC emissions on students in this age group, because students at this age are more affected during their development periods. In Turkey, various studies, especially for primary schools, were conducted in different years. However, only so limited studies examined indoor air quality and VOCs in higher education buildings. Therefore, with the help of the table, we decided to analyze the existing conditions of higher education buildings in Turkey. Although some studies are examining Higher education buildings, they are more limited than the other studies. Therefore, it is very important to examine these educational buildings to contribute to the literature. This is especially significant for faculties where the tools, equipment, and materials used in their education, such as architecture and engineering, lead to VOCs. Thus, this study aims to investigate the VOCs in higher education buildings by comparing two different faculty buildings. For the case study, the Faculty of Architecture and the Faculty of Engineering buildings of Trakya University were chosen. The investigation was done with the help of the measurement in each faculty building at the same time during the course time in winter. The study was carried out in Edirne, which has a humid temperate climate. Temperate in summer and cold in winter, the hottest months are from June to September. In the figure, you can see the location, the building themselves from exterior to interior of the CAS buildings. The Faculty of Architecture building is located in the city center and was built by Sultan Abdulaziz in 1871. The building has two floors and was built in a masonry structure system. The Faculty of Engineering building, which is located outside of the city center between the city bus station and the belt highway connection, has three floors and was built in a reinforced concrete frame system. To determine the differences and the reasons of the indoor air quality in both buildings, we should know their physical properties and finishing materials. You can see the selected spaces in the first table and their interior finishing materials in the second one. According to tables, the spaces that are examined in two buildings have different locations. Size and activities such as classrooms, workshops, and or laboratories. The physical properties of each investigated space in the buildings are almost similar. Only in the Faculty of Architecture buildings, wall boards with XPS covered by textile exist. This can be an important parameter to show differences in VOC emissions. In summer seasons, both buildings cannot be cooled by natural can be cooled by natural ventilation. Now I will briefly explain the process of the study. Measurements were taken between November and December 2015 during the education period on weekdays. Although many VOC exist in the literature, the study focused on the most hazardous ones such as benzene, formaldehyde, toluene, ethyl benzene, xylene, and styrene. Gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, one of the most common analytical methods to analyze VOCs, was used with the help of the Trakya University Technology Research Development Application and Research Center. For tube analysis, air samples were collected by 10xTA sorbents, and these samples were analyzed by using the thermal desorption method in gas chromatography mass spectrometry. Accordingly, the obtained results were given graphically. To determine the statistically significant difference between the data, independent sample test, t-test, was performed and the results were evaluated. Finally, the results were compared to data obtained from the literature. In this slide, you can see the graphs of the obtained results in the study. First column shows the results belong to the Faculty of Architecture, and the second one is the Faculty of Engineering. In the last column, overall comparison results of both buildings exist. VOC is determined at different sampling points with active sampling were given in microgram for cubic meter concentration. Moreover, in the study, to determine the effects of students in the emissions of VOCs and show the differences, the measurements were conducted twice for each space. You can see green color is for empty spaces and brown color is for full spaces. According to the figure, the highest values of benzene, formaldehyde, toluene, and styrene were obtained by the spaces in the Faculty of Architecture building, while ethyl benzene and xylene were in the engineering. Figure also shows that there is an important difference between the spaces are full or empty. This shows the effects of users and their activities on VOCs. Furthermore, the highest results were obtained at the end of the lessons and after cleaning the spaces. As you can see, first column in the figure, belong to the spaces used as workshops or laboratory. In these spaces, concentrations are higher. Moreover, the significance of the difference between the results was statistically evaluated by independent sample t-test. The investigation was carried out in two different ways, namely for the selected spaces in each building and for the results that overall sum of the separate spaces in the buildings. You can see the last column for overall sum of the buildings. Firstly, data for the both buildings show that statistically no significant difference was found. P-value greater than 0.05 in terms of spaces themselves. Much more differences that are significant were obtained in the comparison of the buildings. These are benzam for both when spaces are used or empty, and then formaldehyde for the empty spaces. And moreover, xylene for spaces used. In addition to the statistical evaluation given according to the measurements results, comparing these data with the results in the literature is very important for making inferences that are more comprehensive. In the table, measured values are given with values in the literature together with their minimum, mean, and maximum values. If the reference study does not highlight one or more of these values, it is stated as not available data. As table shows that the values in the Faculty of Architecture like benzen, formaldehyde, toluene, and ethyl benzene are above than the literature. The data of the Faculty of Engineering are close to the results in the literature, particularly for benzen and formaldehyde. For only xylene, both results in the buildings are below than the literature. When the buildings are compared based on their functions, the similarity exists in only the xylene between the Faculty of Architecture of Trakya University and the Faculty of Fine Arts of Anadolu University. The reference 7 belongs to the Anadolu University study. However, the Faculty of Architecture has lower values on toluene and ethyl benzene, while benzene is high in Faculty of Fine Arts. According to the results, some differences exist between two analyzed buildings. Here, you can see the important factors that lead to these differences. First one is different location of the of two faculty buildings. The second, the total amount of interior finishing materials. Third one, the limited area of the windows used for ventilation. Fourth, material used for the activities. And finally, age of the buildings. In this study, VOC measurements were examined in the education buildings where adult students study and spend most of their time in. According to the results obtained by the two different faculty buildings of higher education, some VOC values show similarities while some of them are different. Ethyl benzene, stearin, xylene show the similar values to each other. However, benzene, formaldehyde, toluene and stearin are higher in the Faculty of Architecture building. The empty space measurements of ethyl benzene and xylene are highest in the Faculty of Engineering. Statistically, significant difference was found for benzene, formaldehyde, and xylene between two faculty buildings. It was determined that the location and nature of ventilation of the buildings are effective in determining the indoor air quality in terms of VOCs if the indoor finishing materials are the same. The amount of VOC in the indoor environment is also increasing in city centers where the outdoor air does not sufficiently ventilate the indoor. In addition, the limited ventilation possibilities also affect this situation negatively. The spaces such as workshops and laboratories are the places with the highest VOC emission considering the coarse materials used in the indoor environment. Finally, I would like to finish our presentation with some recommendation for future studies. In this study, the measurements were conducted only for winter conditions. If measurements are taken for spring and summer conditions in future studies, seasonal comparison can be made. With adding a survey for students, a detailed examination of the symptoms that may occur on students in case of long-term exposure to VOCs can be determined. Thank you for your listening. You can find more information in our full paper. Have a good conference. Thank you.